SoCal Connected is made possible through the generous support of the Amundsen Foundation, serving the Los Angeles community since 1952.
On tonight's SoCal Connected. Influencers, they are everywhere.
Social media marketing today is really the wild, wild west of commerce.
If you have a larger following, more people are going to pay attention to you and you have more influence.
I think making viral videos is like a drug. You want it, you get addicted to it.
Where I just needed to get that next viral video.
You may not know it, but you're living under the influence.
In the end, people have some sort of talent, even if that talent is no talent.
I like the outfits of like Rocky Barnes and Sincerely Jules. Like, oh, this is how I wear it, like giving people advice.
I follow Suzanne Hendrick.
Irene Sara.
And Olivia Pope, I love
her. I like Kim K's stuff and Styled by Foosh. Her stuff's amazing. All the Kardashian stuff. But anyone with good clothes and stuff you can actually buy.
James Charles.
I love him.
Shane Dawson.
Yes.
Andrew Russett.
She's gorgeous.
Of course.
Influencers. If you're not one of them, you're probably following them. Being influenced to buy the right products, wear the right clothes, or go to the hottest places. They're the tastemakers, brand ambassadors, beauty gurus, and trendsetters of the internet generation. And being liked, followed, and shared is a big business.
Influencers are fascinating to me because they're the new breed of celebrity now.
It's every day, bro, with the Disney Channel flow. 5 mil on YouTube in 6 months, never done before.
They could be a prankster. They could be controversial. They could be successful. They could be beautiful. There's an entire industry and there's an entire culture that has come out of this.
It's a culture of buying and selling authenticity, where everyone is an idealized version of themselves.
People are involved in their phones, so they want to paint a beautiful picture of how their lives might be.
Kia Illulian owns a cafe across the street from the famous Pink Wall on Melrose Avenue, where people line up every day to take the perfect photo for Instagram.
I never thought that people would come from across the world to come and take a picture in front of that pink wall. It's a crazy era we live in.
Tourists come to the cafe to get their selfie, Kim Kardashian's face, or popular hashtags printed on their lattes.
I think that every single major influencer has been through our doors with a little bit of filters and some airbrushing. Everybody can be a model these days. There's nothing to stop you. And we welcome that.
Everyone can be a model, but only a handful achieve internet fame, while the rest, many of them teens, are targeted by marketers to buy and sell more products. It's a game of cat and mouse, where everything is commodified and self-expression is turned into subliminal advertising. The real winners are the brands, and of course, Instagram. The platform has an estimated worth of over $100 billion. As for the influencers, it all starts with a like.
So when I first started my Instagram, I had probably like 100 followers. It was just me and the people that I knew directly. It was mostly just my friends following me because I was young and my mom didn't really want me having like random people following me, you know? When I was in eighth grade, I made my account public and then I started getting more people following me. And then I realized that the more people who follow me, the more influence and reach I have. Right now I have between 14 and 15,000 followers.
Adorable. The blue urns behind you make your eyes stand out.
Good.
Generally, I take the photos of Emily because, well, I'm here and I've got the phone and it's just easy. And I think I have an eye for what looks great on her and sort of her Instagram aesthetic.
I love this one. It's so cute.
Christina Zilber runs a cosmetics company and has over 40,000 followers of her own. So she knows a thing or two about crafting an image.
It was a big decision to let her go public. I know a lot of kids her age are still private, just because you don't know where that line is crossed between, you know, strangers kind of peering into your life and finding out where you live and all of that. So it makes me a little bit nervous, but I think she's mature enough and handles herself well.
I think in posting photos of myself, I'm more inclined to check the likes, compare the amount of comments I'm getting to someone else, and be like, oh, my nose isn't as good as this person, my eyes aren't as pretty, my smile isn't as big, you know? But then in posting, you also get a bunch of people commenting like, oh, you're so beautiful, gorgeous, pretty, amazing, you know? And then that sort of like feeds your ego a little bit.
But Amelie wanted to be more than just a pretty face. She created a new Instagram page called 2 Minute Times to educate teens about politics.
I knew that kids my age weren't paying attention and they didn't really know about the topics that were being discussed or the issues that were going on in our world. And I knew that Instagram was where they were and it was the perfect way to actually get them engaged and aware about what was going on around them.
But she noticed people were much more likely to comment on her selfies than her political message.
If I just post a photo of our president, Donald Trump, I will get no engagement whatsoever. But if I post a photo of myself with a caption that has to do with Donald Trump, I will get so many more likes, so many more comments. And the sad thing is those comments will be, oh, you're so pretty, oh, you're so like gorgeous, perfect, whatever, and nothing about what I actually have to say.
At its core, Instagram is a photo-based platform. Even if you have a message, it's the image that attracts followers.
The ways you attract somebody hasn't changed from 100 years ago. You know, you're either intelligent or interesting or fascinating or controversial. That hasn't really changed. It's the way of communicating it. But on social media, the word says it all, social media.
Seeing someone who looks just like us, having experiences we want, is what influencers are all about. They're aspirational. And the easiest way to achieve their lifestyle is to have the same things they have, their clothes, their makeup, their fitness routines, and vacations.
These brands can reach their consumers directly. They can figure out geographically where they want to reach. They can figure out the age. They can figure out the sex of the consumer, and they can go after that influencer that has that sort of audience and sell directly to those people. It's direct access to the consumer that you're wanting to target.
Influencers with large followings can charge as much as $20,000 to $200,000 per post. The top ones can earn in the millions. But brands also target so-called micro-influencers, like Amelie. They flood them with products, hoping they'll show up in their feeds.
Getting free stuff is really cool because I get to keep it and wear it and share it on my platform and get more people to see what I'm wearing and purchase it themselves.
Today, I'm doing an unboxing. Look at this, it's a Marc Jacobs beauty box.
Super adorable packaging, look at.
For Gen Z and a millennial, this is where they're getting their information. But it's constant. When they pick up their phone, they go and they check their Instagram specifically. They're scrolling through and they're being influenced. They're being sold to. And this is what brings them to purchasing product at the end of the day.
Okay, I see like a million beauty gurus posting about the Sand and Sky clay mask. It's like this pink clay mask.
Yeah.
And I bought it and I use it like every other day and it's so good. So that was definitely like a push and everything. A lot of the Instagram beauty gurus, those are the ones that'll get you.
Like, yeah.
They will get
They're
you
good
with
at convincing,
that.
For
They're
sure.
They're very good at convincing.
And the influencing goes beyond just posting. Influencer parties happen every night of the week in Los Angeles. Brands pay them to attend and take photos of their products. Chris Pan owns a jewelry line. He's a regular at these parties.
Influencers are very important to us because it adds credibility, it adds reach. People are influenced by people at the end of the day, right? And so if you see someone that you admire, see someone that you respect, they're wearing their bracelet, I mean, that certainly helps.
Social media marketing today is really the wild, wild west of commerce. Nobody knows where it's going, nobody knows where it's coming from. But we do know that there's a shift of billions and billions of dollars of spend to social media marketing and influencer marketing.
But many of those influencers might not realize exactly what they're getting themselves into when their numbers start to climb.
I started using Instagram 7 months ago. I posted a picture of me and Bill Nye in the gym, and I guess it went kind of viral. So when I saw the likes going up on the picture, I felt confused and I didn't know what was happening. And then people started reposting it and it got more attention, I guess.
You say that I have about 29,000 followers. I'm like, how do you get all these people? Do you, you know, he said, well, I guess I'm hot.
Robert Safar started using his Instagram to talk about music he liked, a genre called sad boys.
I like melodic rap, I guess you can call it. I mean, a lot of artists follow me and like a lot of artists like know who I am. Lil Nar DM'd me because I put him on my story because I was listening to a song. And he said, gang, appreciate that, family. And then we've been talking.
Yeah.
Brands just started hitting me up, asking me to promote their clothing. So I said yes. So this is a shirt I got today. It's called it says Bloom on it. Here's from like a hoodie from another brand. Here I have a shirt from a company called Half Evil. I got this one hat. I don't really know what this means, but it's like cool, I guess. Then some company sent me like a shirt with waffles on it. I don't know why. I guess I consider myself an influencer. I have no clue what an influencer means or is.
When Robert first started getting, packages in the mail, at first I was really shocked. Like, I mean, who would send the package to Robert? Then I asked him, I say, who are these people, you know? He say, oh, that's from Instagram. I'm like, Instagram, who's Instagram?
It's like weird people following what I do and stuff like that. It's a lot of eyes on me, and it's kind of scary. I don't know, I get a lot of DMs asking for help. Like, some of them are, like, depressed, or some, like, have anxiety, and they don't know how to deal with it. So they try to ask me for help, and I try to do as best I can, but I'm only 14, so I don't know about the real world that much. It's like, people are really mean on the internet. So, like, if I say anything wrong, people get mad. Like, some will be like, kill yourself, so I just delete those. Then, like, some call me, like, a fag. I'm, like, because I'm Middle Eastern, people, like expect me to be, like, they just comment, like, you're, like, a, like, they comment, like, rich Arab fag or, like, stuff like that. Maybe they just don't like me. I don't know. I guess I don't let it bother me, but, like, to an extent, it bothers me.
As a young kid, getting millions of followers, I think can be a really dangerous thing. I feel like humans weren't made to be famous or popular, and it causes a lot of pressure and stress unnecessarily on your life.
At 28 years old, Zach King is an industry veteran.
Please welcome Zach King.
He became social media royalty And like all great things on the internet, it started with a cat video.
I grabbed my buddy's kittens. Aaron and I filmed a video with them. We added the lightsabers in, and all of a sudden, we posted it. We made it in like 12 hours. Posted it, and it had millions of views. Cat videos and Star Wars are a great mix. If you mix the two, viral gold. Print money.
King's currency is his 45 million followers across Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. His videos have been seen over a billion times, and watching the numbers go up is addictive.
I've never done drugs, and so I don't know the feeling, but I always say, like, I think making viral videos is like a drug. You get addicted to it, and you want to figure out, like, why is that working? Let's make another one and duplicate that.
It can also mean pushing the boundaries.
My name's Joe. I'm filming a social experiment. Now, how many times a day do you tell your kid not to talk to strangers?
YouTuber Joey Saladino, who goes by Joey Salads, creates what he calls social experiments, but they're basically prank videos.
And I'm going to make it look like I'm bashing the car in with this hammer.
In one of his most watched videos called Abduct Children,
you like the puppies, right?
Saladino shows parents how easy it is to be a predator. It's his version of a public service announcement.
Over 700 children are abducted a day. That's over 250,000 a year. Are your kids safe? Overnight, it had like 40 million views, and I woke up with like emails from like Fox, NBC, CNN. Every major broadcasting station wanted to have me on. And from there, that's when things really took off.
I'm not really a parenting expert. I just made a video.
With dreams of making it big, Saladino moved to Hollywood. He shares space with other social media stars in this apartment building known as 1600 Vine. He now has 7 million followers.
At a million, you get the plaque. They give you like a big golden plaque. At like 100,000, they give you a small one. And then at 10 million, they send you like a diamond play button. So right here is the Vine logo, and this arm is my Facebook and YouTube arm. There's my dad as an ogre yelling at me. This one's my favorite tattoo. It's Chinese writing, and it actually says pork fried rice.
As his followers grew, so did his bank account.
A lot of people say, like, the American dream is dead. But nowadays, I feel like the American dream is more alive than ever because you can make six figures a year without even leaving your house. I run about $100,000 worth of brand deals a month. I wake up, I have my laptop on the side, I'm laying in bed, I roll the laptop over and I'm just handling emails.
But when Saladino's social experiments went from slapstick to political, they became controversial.
What's up guys, Joey Salads here. And you may have seen on the internet and through the polls that a lot of black people don't like Trump. And they don't even like his supporters in some cases. So what I did was, I got a car, put some Trump apparel on it, and we're gonna park it in a black neighborhood and see what happens. So at the time of the election, I was on a rampage. I was on fire. I was just making tons and tons of political videos. They were all going viral. So it was almost like an addiction.
The Trump car bashing video has over 2 million views. It was used by conservative websites like the Drudge Report as evidence that black people actively hated Donald Trump and his supporters. When people discovered it was fake, YouTubers and news outlets attacked Saladino for race baiting.
The black actors who smashed the Trump car,
how
much did you pay them?
I didn't even pay them.
People feed off of super edgy, super controversial videos, especially even if it's exposed as fake or racist or race baity. That's what people thrive on. That's what makes it viral. So I'm out here at a bar today, and I'm gonna figure out how easy it is to drug a girl.
It may not have been what he intended, but Saladino is now an idea influencer, and he shows no signs of stopping. His videos have over 70 million views.
Is the entire social implication of what being an influencer is. You're living your life publicly, and your followers follow you for a reason, and sometimes that reason is contrary to the ethical or moral way or the way you should lead your own life. So that's the dark side of social media that I see sometimes.
When I was first speaking 10 years ago at schools, there was an obvious, like, hey, what do you guys want to be someday? And they're like, I want to be an astronaut. I want to be a doctor. I want to be a lawyer. Like, all the classic stuff kids want to be. And now it's like,
every single time you ask the entire, like 90% of the audience will say, I want to be a YouTuber, or I want to be an Instagram model, or I want to be a beauty guru or a gamer on live streams. And it's amazing to see that that is now a career that kids see as an option for them.
Influencing is becoming so mainstream that it sounds like a great career option. Why have a 9-to-5 when you can make your first million taking selfies? But there's no roadmap for how to go from 0 to 10 million followers overnight. Not everyone goes viral.
I think my dream job is to just sit in front of a camera and do YouTube full time and make money that way. Right now, I work at Starbucks. I'm a supervisor and I'm working full time. And then on the side, I'm, you know, uploading to social media.
Rebecca has a college degree in wildlife management, but she gave it up to pursue a career as a makeup influencer. Gambling on a social media gig to pay the bills is nothing unusual for this generation, who've seen traditional jobs dry up. Plus, being influential looks so easy, but it's not.
A lot of brands don't pay attention to people with smaller followings. It's harder to get reposted if you don't have a following.
Rebecca has tried to be an influencer for 2.5 years. She has 1,500 subscribers on YouTube and 900 on Instagram.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel.
It can be really frustrating, actually. It can also be discouraging. If I wanted to, I can go in and like highlight my cheekbones. I guess it doesn't look that bad. And then if you want, sometimes I'll like to edit my nose.
Do you not like your nose?
I don't. Because there is like, in the beauty community at least, it's very saturated right now. And there's a lot of people that want to do what these big YouTubers are doing. And so it's hard to get your name out there. It's hard to stand out.
Once influencers already have a following, the free products help them get more. But if your numbers are low and marketers haven't found you, you have to buy your own products.
So today's video is going to be a beauty haul of some stuff that I've purchased over the past like week or so.
How much do you spend on makeup? Like if you were to estimate it?
Too much. So I think I spend around maybe like $400 a month on makeup, give or take a couple hundred. But it is financially draining having to purchase makeup all the time. Beauty companies just make it hard in that way. You know, like they're gonna choose the people who already have a bigger following and they're gonna keep growing those influencers as opposed to the smaller people who are trying to grow. And I don't know the answer to how somebody gets over that.
It's not easy to grow now. It's not as easy as it was. The market can only follow so many people, just like how many television channels can one watch at once?
You go through phases as a creator. You have your ups and downs. You see creators who 3 years ago had 90 million views a month, and now they're getting 5 million views. It's still a lot of views, but it can be a depression for them.
That's another dark side of being an influencer. Pressure to be on display, to keep your numbers up, to stay relevant, but also to have the right message.
Once you will have an influence on what you're creating and the people that are watching it, and what's that influence gonna be, that's up to the creator.
A lot of people call themselves social media influencers, but you're influencing people to do what? Is it to reach a level of beauty that is not attainable naturally? Is it to have people lust after cars or material objects that will never bring somebody true happiness? So I just have one question for every influencer, because we're all influencers. And that question is, when people come to your page, do they walk away better or worse?
But even with the pitfalls, the pressure, the negative comments, and the rocky road to making it big or not, most influencers say they won't stop. And influencer marketing isn't going away anytime soon.
Instagram definitely makes people turn on each other or like try to use each other.
Do you want to keep doing this?
I mean, yeah, because like I get I don't know, like I have like people are nice to me too. And then like I've met a lot of people through it.
I don't think I would give up on trying to become an influencer. I think this is something that I always want to do. And whether or not I get a following from it, this is just like my life now.
I don't know, I'm just keep doing what I'm doing because everything's constantly going up. The views are going up, revenue's going up. The end goal in 10 years from now is going to be being at the top of social media.
I'm not sure like where Instagram will be in the next 10 years, but when I'm 25, I don't really know what it's going to be like looking back. It might be really cool. It might be kind of embarrassing. I have no idea.
Yeah.